everyone. In today's video, I'm going to share with you how you can start making money from your photography. I am a full-time photographer and I have been for the past 10 years or so. And I've made money doing lots of different types of photography over the years, which I will get into later on in this video. But I wanted to start off by saying that the first client is often the hardest to get. Once you get your first client, everything's going to slowly grow from there and you will build up your client base. It's all about getting that first person to book you for a job. That's the most important thing when starting your business. Building up your client base gradually is also a great way for you to be able to grow with your business while you're doing photography. Instead of diving into the deep end and having 100 clients in one go in your first year of your photography business, you'll be able to grow that slowly so you know how to manage your time. So my first piece of advice is don't buy a camera expecting to make money. I know that sounds a little bit counterintuitive, but just hear me out. Photography isn't all about taking photos. It's also about running your own small business and nowadays also having a social audience as well. It's completely possible to work from the morning to the middle of the night, 7 days a week, and still never be up to date with everything that you need to do. And trust me, I've been there. So making sure that photography is right for you and that you're passionate about it is a very important first step, because you're going to be spending hours upon hours putting time into your business in order to be able to help it grow and to be able to make it a full-time job. So when I first started photography, it was just a hobby. I ended up picking up my family's point and shoot camera and I would take it with me whenever we went on road trips and stuff like that, and I would just take photos of everything. And eventually I realized that photography was something that I was really, really interested in. So from that, I ended up getting my very first digital SLR camera, which from memory was a Pentax K100D with some sort of kit lens on it. And I got it because I wanted to hone my skills in photography. I wanted to learn how to use an SLR camera in manual mode. I wanted to learn what different lenses did. I wanted to be able to take more control over my creativity. I wanted to experiment and I wanted to take higher quality images. While I was creating all these images, I would upload them to my accounts on Flickr and DeviantArt because I wanted advice from the creative community there on what I could do to improve my work and what I could do differently as well. Because I had my work online for everyone to see, I was very, very lucky with my first client, and a company had actually emailed me asking to license one of my images for a book cover. Which brings me to one of the biggest points in being able to make money with your photography, which is having an online presence. So this doesn't mean that you have to go out and reach a million followers on Instagram and have thousands of people following you on Twitter. That is important in its own way, but not specifically for getting clients. My point with getting an online presence is to simply share your work online. And this might sound really simple, but I feel like it's so simple that sometimes it's really easy to forget. You can't expect to book in any clients if you don't have anything to show for all those months or years that you spent building up your skills as a photographer. A lot of people are actually using Instagram as a portfolio nowadays, but I still find that having your own website is extremely important. Instagram is a great way to be able to share the work that you're doing at the moment. So maybe you'll be sharing a photo shoot that you did last week, or you could share a behind the scenes, or you might share like your travel photos that you take. But a website really defines who you are as a photographer and shows the client what you're available to be booked for. So if you want to be a portrait photographer, I would recommend to upload your strongest portrait photography on your website and save your travel photos to be uploaded to Instagram instead. That way, when a client lands on your website, they know exactly what they can expect from you. And if you've got a portrait session that's something that they really want, they'll get in contact with you to be able to book that session in with you. So I like to share advice and tips with you guys on things that I've personally experienced. So for me as a photographer, I have a portrait and fashion photography business, and I also have a wedding photography business. Since they are two completely different styles of photography, I decided to split the two of them up. So the portrait and fashion photography is under my name with its own website, and then the wedding company that Dan and I have is under Swoon Weddings with its own website as well. That way, when clients find our website, it's not super confusing as to what we do. It's super clear that we either shoot portrait photos or we shoot weddings. Starting off with portrait photography, there are so many different styles of portrait sessions that you can specialize your business to and offer to your clients. So you have things like standard portrait sessions where you could specialize in taking headshots for actors. You could also shoot model portfolio photos for freelance models or for modeling agencies. You could do senior sessions, which I believe is a really big thing in the States. And you could also do things like family sessions and newborn photography. For each of these categories that I mentioned, I personally know a photographer who has built their business around one of these categories and specializes in just offering that and have turned their photography into a full-time job. So for me personally, I mostly shoot model portfolios for freelance models and modeling agencies, and I also offer portrait sessions for anyone who just wants some nice photos of themselves. Now, with fashion photography, there are also so many categories that you could fall under. If you want to own your own studio, you could specialize in doing lookbook or e-commerce photography, where a clothing brand can hire you to shoot all the outfits of a new collection that they have. You could also do these lookbooks and e-commerce shoots on location, which is what I did for a few years as well. You can also shoot fashion campaigns, which are creative on-location photo shoots, and these kinds of photos are usually used on the brand's website, in their newsletter, on social media, in advertising, and sometimes even on billboards. And with fashion photography, you could also look into getting your own agency representation to be able to book bigger and better jobs. Last but not least, there is wedding photography, which is a great way to make money and probably the most stability you'd have as a photographer, since weddings are usually booked about a year or two in advance. So unlike portrait photography and fashion photography, which is normally only booked maybe a month or two in advance, with weddings, you'll already know what your whole next year is going to look like, so you won't have any scary surprises that there might be a month or two where you won't book any jobs. So don't be fooled by weddings though. I find that they are so demanding as just a person and as a photographer when you're first getting into it and you're learning the ropes. With a wedding, you're often doing so many different styles of photography on the one day. So first of all, you've got documentary photography where you have to capture people in the moments as they happen. You also do product photography because you need to get beautiful photos of the rings and the bride's jewelry and the shoes and little details like that. There's also a little bit of architecture photography because I love getting a really beautiful photo of the venue that the couple are getting married in. And you also have portrait photography where you're taking photos of people who may never have modeled in their life. There's also group shots to take. You're doing low light photography using camera flashes. There's just so many different aspects to wedding photography. With weddings, there's also the added pressure that moments usually only happen just once. So you need to be really comfortable with your camera in order to be able to capture those moments, such as the first kiss or maybe the parents or the grandparents crying and little moments like that. It's not all despair though if the sounds of that really freaks you out. If you want to get into wedding photography, what I did when I first started was offered my services to wedding photographers who I really admired as a second shooter. So in case you don't know, a second shooter has a few different jobs in the day depending on who you're working for. On the one hand, you could be more of an assistant where you're helping the photographer carry their gear while they're running around throughout the day taking photos. Or you could be there just as a second photographer, taking those extra photos and capturing different angles on the moments that are happening, and also taking photos of something when the main photographer is busy with the bride and groom. This is not only a way to get comfortable with weddings and learn how they work and know when you're ready to be able to shoot a wedding on your own, but you also get paid while you're learning, which is so, so great. Plus, you'll have the images that you take from that day to be able to use in your portfolio. Just a note, if you are going to use those photos that you took at a wedding as a second shooter, I would personally make it quite clear on the website or in your blog that you were the second shooter, as you don't really want to take credit for the main photographer's posing and things like that. Something that I did while I was starting out my photography business that Casey Neistat mentioned in his videos and it rang so true to me was that I said yes to every opportunity that involved me holding a camera. When I first started out with photography and I wanted to book in clients, I said yes to absolutely everything because I wanted to make as many connections as possible in the industry. You never know who you might shoot with that might recommend you for a really amazing job. I would even say yes to things that were outside of my field of portrait and wedding photography because it's really great to experiment with different styles of photography when you're starting out, especially in order to see if you might like doing something better. So if you thought that you maybe wanted to be a fashion photographer and you do a couple of family sessions and you end up really loving them, you could change your business strategy to suit more family portraits instead. As I mentioned in one of my previous videos, it's also good to shoot for free every now and again for a different experience or to make a new connection with someone in the industry. So, like I mentioned in the other video, it's not about shooting something completely for free, like a campaign or a lookbook for a brand where they're going to be making money off the photos. But I would, however, put together a couple of free test shoots with agency models to be able to test out new ideas and to be able to take the style of photos that I want or I feel like are missing from my portfolio. You could also try asking a friend or someone you know who also has a small business and ask them if they mind if you took a few portraits of them. This way you get the chance to see what a client photo shoot would be like, and your friend would have some really nice photos that they could upload to their website. And if they like the photos, they might actually call you back to do some actual photography work for their website too. Well, this probably ended up being a really, really long video, but there is just so much to talk about when it comes to having your own photography business and making money with your camera. I really, really hope you guys found this helpful. I love hearing from you guys, so please leave all your comments down below, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.